Welcome to OFAR. In this tutorial, I'll be guiding you on how to assemble the Malm 6-drawer dresser from IKEA. For this build, you need a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver, a drill, a hammer, a 5/16 inch drill bit, and a pencil. If you want to speed up the assembly process, then you can also use a Phillips or Posi drive bit. Before you start, I'd also recommend keeping all the bits and pieces in their intended bags, as mixing them up will cause more confusion. So first, grab this middle panel and put it into this orientation. Just make sure these two bigger holes that I pointed to are in the bottom right corner. Also grab 3 CR drawer slides and 9 of these small screws from bag 1. Then secure each CR drawer slide with 3 screws. The whole process will look like this. Now flip the panel over. Also, grab 3 CL drawer slides and 9 more small screws. Next, secure each CL drawer slide with 3 screws. Then grab 4 of these screws and screw them into these 4 holes. Now grab 2 larger dowels and hammer them into these 2 holes. Then bring in these 2 side panels and put them into this orientation. These 2 pairs of holes that I pointed to should be located here. Also grab 3 CL and 3 CR drawer slides and 18 of these small screws. Now for this panel, secure each CR drawer slide with 3 screws like this. As for this panel, secure each CL drawer slide with 3 screws. Now grab 8 of these screws and screw them into these 8 holes. Then grab these 8 pieces of wood and put them into this orientation. Also grab 16 smaller sized dowels. Now hammer in the dowels into these 16 holes. Next, attach these 2 pieces of wood like this. Then grab 2 camlock nuts and secure them into these 2 holes. Next, attach these 3 pieces of wood like this. Then connect the last 3 pieces of wood as shown. Now grab 6 cam lock nuts and secure them into these 6 holes. Next, grab these 2 pieces of wood and put them into this orientation. Also grab 4 of these metal braces and 8 of these screws. Now secure each metal brace with 2 screws. The whole process will look like this. Then do the same thing with the other piece of wood. Then grab 4 scratch guards and hammer them into these 4 spots. Then grab 4 more screws and attach the metal brace like this. Then secure it using 2 screws. Now with the other 2 screws, secure the metal brace as shown. Then bring in the middle panel and put it into this orientation, then attach it as shown. Next, grab 4 cam lock nuts and secure them into these 4 holes. Now grab 2 more screws and secure them into these 2 holes. Then grab 4 of these screws and screw them into these 4 holes. Next, grab 6 plastic scratch guards and hammer them into these 6 spots. Now flip and turn these structures like this, and then connect them as shown. Then grab three camlock nuts and secure them into these three holes. Next, grab two more screws and screw them into these two holes. Now turn the structure around 180 degrees. You may need another person's help in this step. Then grab the top panel and put it into this orientation. Just make sure the two small holes that I pointed to are in this location. Also, from the wall hardware bag, grab two metal brackets, two washers, and two small screws. To secure the bracket, put the screw through the washer and then secure the bracket. Do the same thing to the other side as well. Now grab six of these screws and screw them into these six holes. Then grab two smaller dowels and hammer them into these two holes. Next, attach the top panel like this. Now grab four camlock nuts and secure them into these four holes. Then grab two of the metal camlock nuts and secure them into these two holes. Now turn the structure 180 degrees and lay it on the floor like this. Next, grab one cam lock nut and secure it into this hole. Now grab the backing and place it on as shown. Then from the nail bag, grab one nail and make sure that the top left corner is flush. Then hammer in the nail into this spot. Now grab another nail and make sure everything is flush. Then hammer it into this spot. Next, grab one more nail and make sure that the bottom left corner is flush. Then hammer it into this spot. Then grab the other backing and place it on as shown. Now grab one nail and make sure that the top right corner is flush. Then hammer the nail into this spot. Next, grab another nail and make sure everything is flush. Then hammer it into this spot. Now grab one more nail and make sure that the bottom right corner is flush. Then hammer the nail into this spot. Then grab the rest of the nails and hammer them equidistant of each other all around the backing and also down the middle of the spine. Now put the dresser against your intended wall and then grab the wall hardware bag. I've done these steps already in another video, so I'll leave a link with the timestamp in the description below if you want to secure this dresser to drywall properly. So now let's focus on the drawers. Grab this front drawer piece and put it into this orientation. Also grab four of these screws from bag two and screw them into these four holes. Then grab these two side drawer pieces and put them into this orientation. Also grab four of these dowels and hammer them into these four holes. Now connect both side drawer pieces like this. Next, grab four cam lock nuts and secure them into these four holes. Now grab the bottom of the drawer and attach it as shown. Then grab the back of the drawer and put it into this orientation. Also grab this metal piece and hammer it in gently into this spot. Just make sure the metal piece is facing more towards the inside. This end should be sticking out more. Now attach the back of the drawer like this. Next, grab four plastic pins and hammer them into these four holes. Then flip the drawer over and grab the DL and DR drawer slides and six of these small screws. Now for this side, grab the DL drawer slide and secure it with three screws. As for the other side, grab the DR drawer slide and secure it with three screws. Now repeat the same steps that relate to the drawer five more times. Now to put in the drawers, first grab the only one with the warning sticker on it. Then unlock this locking mechanism by moving it up slightly. Now you can put in the drawer with the warning sticker into this spot. Then unlock the locking mechanism again in the middle and put in any drawer. And again, unlock the lower locking mechanism one more time and then put in the drawer. Now do the same thing with the three drawers on the other side. So this locking mechanism limits only one drawer being pulled out at a time on each side of the dresser. Now check that everything opens and closes relatively smoothly, but if you followed all these steps, then you shouldn't have any issues. So you now have a fully assembled Malm 6-drawer dresser from IKEA. Hopefully this tutorial helped you out.